Hello students, welcome to digital class. Today we will discuss about evidences of evolutions. Generally, accumulation of variations in large number that leads to the formation of a new species. This is the way of evolution. Look at here. Here, in red beetle population, one variation, green beetle, appeared. Over two successive generations, finally, a new species formed. That means evolution occurred. It is an assumption, but we need the evidence. That's why today we will discuss about evidences of evolution. Here, the first evidence is homologous and analogous organs. The second one is evidences from embryology. And the third one is evidences from fossils. First of all, we will discuss about homologous organs. Here, organs which are structurally similar but functionally different are known as homologous organs. For example, internal structure of forelimb of a whale, leg of a cheetah, hand of a man, these are the examples of homologous organs. Why we are calling homologous organs? Look at here. Hand of a man, leg of a cheetah, and forelimb of a whale. They are showing a common pattern in the arrangement of the bones. Look at there. But these organs are functionally different. These organs are functionally different. Here, hand of the man useful for grasping, leg of the cheetah useful for running, and forelimb of the whale useful for swimming. They are structurally similar but functionally different. So these organs are called as homologous organs. It indicates that all the vertebrates, that means all backbone animals, are evolved from a common ancestor. So this type of evolution is called as the divergent evolution. Okay, once again I am repeating. What are the homologous organs? Organs which are structurally similar but functionally different are known as the homologous organs. The internal structure of the forelimb of the whale, leg of a cheetah, hand of a man, which are internal structure, that means arrangement of the bones are same, but their functions are different. Sorry. So those are the homologous organs. And next one is the analogous organs. What are the analogous organs? Organs which are structurally different but functionally similar. Those are known as the analogous organs. Analogous organs. Examples for these organs are wings of bat, wings of birds. Here, they are structurally different, but their functions are same. Wings of bats have the skin folds stretched between the elongated fingers. Look at here. So wings of the bats have the skin folds stretched between elongated fingers. While wings of birds have a feathery covering all along the arm. So those are structurally different, but their function, what is their function? Flying. So these are called as the analogous organs. Analogous organs. So their origin is different. They are structurally different, but functionally similar, and their origin also differs. This type of evolution is called as the convergent evolution. That means they are structurally different, but they are functionally similar. That means they are evolved from the different ancestors, but they are showing the same function. So this type of evolution is called as convergent evolution. And next one is the next evidence is the evidences from embryology. First of all, we know the definition. What is the embryology? Embryology is the study of development of an organism from egg to adult stage is known as embryology. That means the study and development of an organism from egg to adult stage is known as the embryology. So look at the embryos of different organisms from fish to man. Here, look at here, all the embryos are similar in their development. Here, there are remarkable similarities in the embryos from fish to human. Even though embryologists also cannot identify which embryo belongs to the which organism, it indicates all the organisms from fish to man are evolved from a common ancestor. So this is the evidence of. Now, the last evidence from fossils. Generally, fossils are evidences of ancient life forms or ancient habitats which are preserved by the natural disasters. Here, all the organisms evolved from ancient life forms. It indicates that all the organisms evolved from ancient life forms. Look at here. These are the fossils. Fossil image. This is the fossil image which preserved by the natural process. So it is ancient form from which remaining organisms are formed according to the evidences of fathers. Thank you.